Welcome back, Josh Wright, season number three at the Fleet. And just casting our minds back to your interview after the Boreham Wood game, it was clear how much you wanted to stay at the club. And the fact we're here doing this, it's clear how much the club wanted you to stay as well. I'm guessing staying for another season was a fairly easy process for both sides, was it?
Yeah, look, there's no denying it. I think it's quite evident how much I've loved my time here. I settled in straight away. I've said the words before, I found the love again for the game. And a lot of people always say you're a long time retired, and it'd be different if I felt like I had nothing to give, but I do. I still feel very, very fresh, still feel young in my ways. And to reiterate it, I've loved it. It feels like a home to me. It feels like a big family to me. And I want to stay here for as long as possible and as long as I can keep playing. So there was no debate for me. It was just a matter of a case of getting the deal done, which wasn't difficult. Obviously the club have got a very busy summer ahead. It's not just me, there's obviously other players who are out of contract and been offered new deals, and obviously quite a lot of new players will be coming in as well, so I understand how it works. And it's got done, it's finished in terms of it's signed, and I couldn't be happier. I'm absolutely delighted, and I'm already eager and anxious to get back in to pre-season, to get fit, to get strong, and hopefully have a very successful season next year, and kick on as a football club with me part of it. And as I say, I'm just delighted that it's done.
Yeah, I mean, you've spoken about, you know, how you come to the end of your football career. So has it almost been like a bonus 2 years getting the success we've had here and you being such a big part of it, and now the excitement for a third season?
Yeah, look, I think age is just a number, and everyone retires and stops at different ages when it comes to football for all different reasons. And I'm someone that looks after myself, and obviously there was no denying a couple of years back I was umming and ahhing what to do, and that wasn't in terms of that I didn't have anything left to give. It was other reasons that come into it, and so many that I've mentioned before that we probably don't need to go into now. But each year is another year, and the more I can look after myself, the more that I give myself every chance in terms of fitness and drive. And the big thing for me is if I ever lost that love and that drive for the game. And the last 2 years here, I certainly haven't. It's gone the other way. It's gone up for it. And I love playing for Ebbsfleet. I love playing for the badge. I love the club. I love the fans. And I've really enjoyed my time here. We won the league in the first year. And last year, the last season, I should say, was difficult, a very difficult time. But I had some very high moments, some great moments personally and as a club. And that last day of the season is right up there in terms of, I don't think, achievement maybe is the right word, because that wasn't what we set out to achieve in the start of the season, but it was a day that we had to do something on the back of being very good over the period just before it, but we still knew what was at stake. And the feeling of that day is one that will live long in my memory and forever, you know, because it was a very, very nerve-wracking, anxious day. But on that final whistle, when we got the job done, was a feeling that is right up there in my career. And I want to take that into next year. I want to carry that with us and use that to build, use that as a platform to build. And there's no way we want, and we will let it happen again, that it goes to the last day of the season next year to stay in the division. The only way that'll happen is if what we want will be going the other way in terms of getting out of the division by getting promoted. And we'll have our targets, we'll have our challenges, but it'll be a case of coming back in, getting the group together, getting to know each other, and having a much more successful season than we did last year. That it's a much happier season all round from start to finish for the club.
Yeah, I mean, I was going to ask you about that final whistle at Boreham Wood. All the fans could see what it meant to you, you know, your fist pumping and everything. I think you said it stood really high in your career highlights, and you've played for some big clubs and at higher levels, obviously.
No, I've had promotions in my career, and I've had the odd relegation as well, whether it be that you've played a small part or a slightly bigger part. But I've had some promotions. I've had some high moments of playing at Wembley and scoring goals against some of the big teams in not just the Premier League but the world, in terms of your Man Uniteds and teams like that, and playing at some fantastic stadiums. But that feeling, I think, because there was so much riding on it and so much pressure that had been on our shoulders for such a long time, and you think you'd done it a couple of weeks before, and then suddenly results go against you. And it was a horrible period leading up to it, and I think the relief at the final whistle that I showed, and I think everyone felt was just such a nice feeling that, that came out your body, and it was what we deserved. And I said it on that day, we thoroughly deserved it to stay in the division, and everyone dug in and everyone played their role from top to bottom at the football club, and it's only what this football club deserved. And yes, it was an incredible feeling and one that sits right high up in my career, if you like, for moments. But I don't want that again, nor does this football club want it again. The gaffer doesn't want it again, the players don't. So we need to strive and go for more, and we want to achieve more. And what we can do, we're not sure yet, but we'll have our, as I say, we'll have our goals, and you have to strive for greatness in life, and there's no reason why we can't go and achieve something big next year for this football club. And obviously the stuff will be going on behind the scenes throughout the summer, and then it's down to us when we come back in, it's down to us to look after ourselves now, fitness-wise and mentally and physically, and when we come back in to hit the ground running straight away, and who knows, hopefully we could have a really, really successful, happy season for everyone next year.
You took on the captaincy role during the campaign. That added responsibility. How did that come naturally to you? And you know, that sort of figurehead at the club, you're at that age as well now.
Yeah, I think certain people thrive off of certain things, and that's something that I thrive off. I've captained a few clubs throughout my career, and some big football clubs, and it comes with added pressure, but it's pressure that I like. I thrive off of stuff like that. I'm a leader. I like to organise. I like to dictate. And whether that be with the way I play, or whether that be with my voice, or off the pitch, off the training field, in the training, in the changing rooms, whatever it be, I like to lead. And that's something I thrive off. And it's a proud moment. To captain a football club is a very proud moment. And I felt very proud to captain Ebbsfleet. And I loved it. And it gives me, as I say, an added responsibility, but one that I really, really like and enjoy. And if I can give the individuals in the team and the team as a collective something else, an extra percentage, whether it be 1% or 5%, 10%, 20% more, if I can give them something that can give them a lift, then that means I'm doing my job as well, and that gives me a buzz and helps me go as well. So, yeah, I loved it. And it's something, as I say, that I'm very proud of.
The fans have got very used to your interviews. You're always very honest, very frank and forthright in those. I mean, players can come in and they can say anything to a camera, can't they? But I think the fans know that you're absolutely genuine with your love for this club, and you know that bond with them has just grown year by year.
Yeah, I've played for quite a few football clubs throughout my career, and sometimes you hit it off with fans and sometimes you don't. One or two sets of fans, I would say, in my career have got me completely wrong for different reasons, whether that I've been given the chance or not, but let's put that to the side. But there's one or two other clubs or a few other clubs that I could mention, but the Ebbsfleet fans have, for one reason or another, have taken to me and I've taken to them. I really do see them as my family. They're part of me. They're part of this football club, which I'm part of. And it's not just the players. It's not just the coaching staff, the owners, the director of football, whoever it might be. The fans are a humongous part of a football club. And I know that. I know how that feels. And I love the fans and I hope they love me, or most of them love me. And I love celebrating with them. I love having good times with them. And they deserved that on the last day of the season last year. And they deserve good and success, and they're a real good bunch, real good set of fans, and they're a group that welcome you in, and long may that continue. I can't wait to get back out there and play in front of them again, and as I say, hopefully give them a lot more to cheer about next season.
Yeah, and you said earlier how age is just a number, and but your fitness stats are still up there, still at the top levels. Fitness is obviously really important to you and lengthening your career. I mean, you go into pre-season again, you know, that's what you have to do, isn't it, to perform at this level week after week?
Absolutely. I think you live and learn throughout your career, and I wish I knew back in the day what I know now in terms of that. But I'm someone that prides myself on fitness, someone that likes to look after myself, and I've got to give myself every chance, like everyone has. There's no denying, I know I'm not the most explosive, quickest player that you'll get, but I'm someone that will cover ground, someone that will be very, very fit in terms of your running statistics and stats and that type, and that will be forever with me when I'm playing and when I'm not playing. But if I can keep giving myself every opportunity to keep going and going and going, because I still feel like I've got so much to give on the pitch physically, but also the mental side of it as well, and now I've got the experience with it, and for me age is just a number. I use what I can give now on the football pitch is more than what I could give when I was 21, 22 or 23, 24 through experience and through in know-how and knowing what it takes and certain moments and certain aspects of the game, which I didn't know then. Of course, I might not be as young and in my prime like that, but I certainly feel like I can give a lot more now than I could when I was playing in the Football League and in the Championship. And that's how life works. And if I can give that side of it as well on top of my ability and my fitness levels, then long may that continue.
And how important was the family feel around the club for you coming back? Obviously, your mum and dad are here a lot. Your wife and kids are here a lot. I guess, you know, it's nice to play in front of them and for them to feel part of it as well.
Yeah, it's... I'm very, very family orientated. I've got a big family and I'm now just started one of my own, obviously. I've got my wife and two kids. And it was a big thing for me that, look, in my career, my dad has followed me absolutely everywhere, like up and down the country, as has my granddad and, of course, my mum and brothers, sisters, and obviously my wife as well now, and other people, many, many other people. And I can't thank them enough. I wouldn't have been able to have done it with them. But now I can, the one wish I always wanted in my career was that I'd have at least one child that could see me play football, and to have now two that are wearing the kits here and I can bring them on the pitch at the right time, and they're now seeing it, and probably my eldest certainly, but both of them hopefully soon are getting to an age that they sort of know what's going on now, and that makes me proud again, and that makes me driven that when I'm doing all this work in the off-season now and I'm thinking about doing another year, it's for them. It's, of course, it's for my mum, dad and nan's granddads and brothers and sisters, but it's also now I'm supporting my wife and kids. I'm doing this to put food on the table for my wife and kids. So when I look up on a match day and I see them sitting there or outside on my wife or mum, dad's laps or whoever's laps, and I see them up in the windows, that drives me on, spurs me on to do even better because I'm doing it for them as well as other things.
And finally, we talked about the ambitions of the club this season to go better than we did last season. But since the Boreham Wood game, there's obviously the news of the stadium planning as well. So that's even longer term. Is that something that you take an interest in, the squad and the players?
Absolutely, yeah. I think it's a fantastic project, and it was brilliant to see the news that came out, because I didn't quite, if I'm being brutally honest, I knew more about it maybe when I first come, and I think it went a little bit quiet, or it was one of them that it will happen or won't happen in the right time. And then when I see that come out, it was like, wow, that's another added bonus for the football club. What a couple of weeks it's been for the club. And I think it's amazing. The area, I wouldn't say needs it, but it would be incredible for not just the football club, but the whole area. And to be part of Ebbsfleet right now, and that's all going on, is fantastic. And you can only see, in my opinion, that the club's going in one direction. It's going up because it's got fantastic owners. It's got a fantastic guy in Damien who runs it day to day. He's incredible, one of the best that I've ever worked with in terms of those roles. And now, obviously, with the management team and the staff and a good group of players that are obviously that are building, I think that along with the fans and everything else that comes with a football club, it's certainly heading in the right direction. And it will be amazing to see that if and when it gets done. And who knows? Could I be part of it? We'll have to wait and see in some capacity. But either way, all I want is the best for this football club, so it's a great thing that could be happening.
I was going to say, with your fitness levels, you could still be playing at the new stadium when you're 38 or 39.
You never know, I could be getting wheeled out there one day, you never know.
Brilliant. Great to see you back, Josh.
Thank you very much.